الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، today the hadith is reported by Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله تعالى عنه. Did we talk about Abu Sa'id al-Khudri before? No one remember? So Abu Sa'id radiallahu ta'ala an, he is from Sighar al-Sahaba. He is from the youngest companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was 10 years old when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam immigrated to Al-Madinah. So he believed in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he kept with him. He didn't witness the battle of Badr because he was like 15 years old. Almost 13 years old, he said, and he witnessed the battles after, like here, Khandaq and the other battles, and he passed away on, actually there's a debate between the scholars whether he passed away on the 64th of Al-Hijrah or the 74th of Al-Hijrah. He was one of the pious person, the Sahaba. He was faqih. He was known as a faqih. They said he used to be afqah sighar al-sahaba. He is the best faqih among the youngest sahaba, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he narrated a lot of hadith. He reported a lot of hadith. It's almost 1,170 hadith. In Bukhari and Muslim, almost 43 hadith. In Bukhari alone, 16. In Muslim alone, 52. And when I say alone, that's mean other than the 43 that reported in both Bukhari and Muslim. So both Bukhari and Muslim, they have 43 hadith from a hadith that reported by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Bukhari has 16 extra. Muslim has 52 hadith extra that Bukhari doesn't has. And his father also a Sahabi. His father also a Sahabi. And he witnessed the battle of Uhud and he was a shaheed at that battle, subhanAllah. Do you know the name of the Sahabi Abu Sa'id al-Khudri? What's his name? Sa'ad.
Sa'ad.
Bin Malik bin Sinan. His father is Malik bin Sinan, one of the Sahaba, Allah Ta'ala. So he said that he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, let me read it in Arabic first. So, إنه سمع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا أسلم العبد فحسن إسلامه يكفر الله عنه كل سيئة كان زلفها وكان بعد ذلك قصاص الحسنة بعشر أمثالها إلى 700 ضعف والسيئة بمثلها إلا أن يتجاوز الله عنها. So he reported that he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, if a person impresses Islam sincerely, then Allah shall forgive all his bad sins. And after that starts the settlement of accounts, the rewards of his good deeds will be 10 times to 700 times for each good deed. And the evil deed will be recorded as it is, unless Allah forgives it. This is the hadith. And there is very important points in this hadith. First of all, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the person declare his Islam, فَحَسُنَ إِسْلَامُ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive the hasayyi'at for the one who become Muslim with the one condition, if his Islam would become hasan. And to have a hasan Islam, it means you have sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to believe in him and to obey him with all the ibadat, with all the worshiping. So when you say I'm Muslim, that means you believe in Allah and you should obey him. Right, Umar? If you believe in Allah, you would obey him with all his commands. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command you, you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these commands. So same thing, when someone try to be a Muslim, he should have the sincerity to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some other scholars, they said فَحَسُنَ إِسْلَامُ, it means he continue on the Islam until he dies without any nifaq or shirk, without associating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or become a hypocrite. That's why there is a hadith when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, أَنُؤَاخَذُ بِأَعْمَالِنَا فِي الْجَاهِلِيَةِ, is Allah would like charge us with our bad deeds in ignorance time? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ أَحْسَنَ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ لَمْ يُؤَاخَذْ بِمَا عَمِلَ فِي الْجَاهِلِيَةِ وَمَنْ أَسَاءَ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ أُخِذَ بِالْأَوَّلِ وَالْآخِرِ. He said, if you have Islam Hasan, a good Islam, then Allah will forgive all the previous sins. But if you have bad deeds, evil deeds, then you will be charged for both the Jahiliyyah and Islam. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يُكَفِّرُ اللَّهُ. That means Allah would wipe out, forgive all his bad sins. And this similar to the hadith that Al-Islamu يَهْدُمُ مَا قَبْلَهُ and Al-Islamu يَجُبُّ مَا قَبْلَهُ, that the Islam and even the Hijrah and the Tawbah, it remove, it destroy all the bad and evil actions. Also we have the hadith when Amr bin al-As radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he was one of the mushrikeen before who harmed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, I want to become Muslim, but I have one condition. I want Allah to forgive all my sins. Because he realized that he did a lot of bad things. So now he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I want to become Muslim, now I feel the guilt inside my heart and I want to be Muslim, but one condition, I want Allah to forgive all my bad deeds before. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَمَا عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ يَجُبُّ مَا قَبْلَهُ, you didn't know that Islam would remove all your bad deeds before. So that's why when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, each sin كان أزلفها, he did it before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would wipe it out. So now we know that if a person become a Muslim and he sincerely want to believe in Allah and obey Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive all his bad actions. What about the good actions? What do you think?
Keep
remaining. He will accept his good deeds?
Yeah.
So he did it without being... No, no. He like, now we know that the conditions to have your deeds accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, first of all, to do it for His sake, with the intention. If you don't even know that Allah exists, that your deed will not be accepted, right? So what about the good deeds? It's not mentioned in this hadith.
There is another hadith about the Prophet
Yes.
And she asked him about somebody who was doing this and this good in Jahiliyyah, and said,
Ibn Jad'an. This is Aisha. Yes.
Will not be accepted.
He said it's not accepted because he didn't say,
رَبِّ
اخْبِرْ لِي خَطِيئَتِي يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. But like after I become Muslim, Allah would, because he say, رَبِّ اخْبِرْ لِي خَطِيئَتِي يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. So, what do you think?
This is what I'm saying. Think that Allah will accept it.
Will accept it. Okay, so for the good deeds, some scholars, and I think Bukhari one of them, because he narrated this hadith with this narration. There is another narration that Allah would ask the Malaika to write all his good deeds and remove all the bad deeds. All the bad deeds. And this is from the mercy of Allah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most merciful one. But the Bukhari doesn't say this in his hadith, in his narration. That's why there is some scholars, they said, because the rule that no one will get his deeds accepted unless he do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would remove everything and he will start clean from the point when he gets, when he impressed Islam. But actually, we have the other narration that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma min abdin yuslim fayuhsinu islama aw fayahsinu islama illa kataba Allahu lahu kulla hasanatin zalafaha wa maha anhu kulla khati'atin zalafaha." So this narration also it's right. So this is from the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful. So He would give him his good deeds twice. How many people they get their ajr twice? There is a famous hadith that there is how many kinds of people? There is three kinds of people they get the ajr twice. In the hadith that narrated even in Bukhari and I think Tirmidhi and Nasa'i, I think in Nasa'i as well. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if the slave, the real slave, he did the commands of his master and he fulfilled the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will get his rights or his ajr twice, because he's doing a lot of things for his master. And then he fulfilled the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he gets the ajr twice. And the other one, the one who has a jariya, a slave lady, and then he teach her very well and send her free and marry her for the sake of Allah. And again, for the sake of Allah. He do all this for the sake of Allah, not for his desires. He will get his ajr twice. And the believers from Ahlul Kitab, they believe in the books, and then when the Quran revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they believed in him, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give them their ajr twice. So they said, maybe this is for them. They believe in their book, and they believe in Quran, so they get their ajr two times, twice. And there is even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in one ayah, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابِ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ هُمْ بِهِ يُؤْمِنُونَ وَإِذَا يُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِهِ إِنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مُسْلِمِينَ أُولَئِكَ يُؤْتَوْنَ أَجْرَهُمْ مَرَّتَيْنَ أُولَئِكَ يُؤْتَوْنَ أَجْرَهُمْ مَرَّتَيْنَ. So even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they get the ajr twice. And we even know there is, if sometimes if you make a tawbah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala change your sins into hasanat. This is all from the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one can deny it. Like even if you think it's the condition to have the deeds accepted, to be do it for the sake of Allah, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do whatever He wants. Sometimes He forgives even the sayyi, and we will talk about this. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He forgive all the sins except what?
Shirk.
Illa an yushraka bih. Right?
Even if we don't believe in the prophets.
No. I'll explain this when we go. This is a very, very important point. Now, we have two ayat that Inna Allah yaghfiru dhunuba jami'an. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all the sins. That means include shirk and kufr, right? And this is like when we see someone, he wasn't believe in Allah, or he was an atheist or whatever, he denied all the facts, and then he start practicing Islam, believe in Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive him, right? No doubt. So إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. But there is another ayah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. So how we can put all these ayat together? Anyone knows?
For the people who are not believing before, for them, yes. This is for who already have a belief. But
no.
I'm already curious for the second to know exactly what does it mean.
Okay, this is basics in Islam. You should know that if you still alive, you have the opportunity to make tawbah. So you will be under the rule that إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. You still have the opportunity when you make a tawbah, ask Allah for forgiveness, do good deeds, Allah يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive all sins, including shirk and kufr. But after you die, you go to Allah with the shirk, with the kufr, He wouldn't forgive it, ever. He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. And He forgive whatever less than kufr. So if you die on kufr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will not forgive this. You die on iman, there is a lot of ma'asi, it's to Allah. Maybe He forgive, maybe not. Sheikh.
I just have a question. Like when God say, He forgive everything,
yes.
But not to yashraka bih. I mean, if somebody believe in God, but don't believe in anything else, but he believe in God, does it mean he will forgive his? He don't believe.
We have the hadith that at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take from the hellfire whoever has a small part or portion of iman in his heart. But this, you need to believe in Allah according to His ta'aleem, to His message, right? So, if you believe in Allah and deny His messengers, that you just like pick and choose, you don't really believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you just, there is some people that said, oh, I believe there is a superpower, but I don't really know what is it. This will not be enough. You should believe in Allah and His messengers. So now, Ali, if someone dies on kufr, he already done. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive him or not? Someone kafir, he didn't believe in Allah, and then on the day of judgment, there is any possibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive him. So what if he believed in Allah, but he has a lot of ma'asi, a lot of sins in his life? Maybe. That's good. Good answer. Jazakallah khair. So this is the two ayat, how you understand it. So at the end of this hadith, go back to the hadith, we went a little bit far, but so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive his sins, then the qasas would start. And the qasas, it means the charge for the deeds. If you do good, what's going to happen? If you do something good,
you can put in double reward.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write it 10 times to 700 times. Now this is what the hadith said, 100 to 700 times. Right?
You don't know. It is.
There are some scholars, they said, that's it. 10 times to 700 times.
I mean, we can't know what is it.
But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in one ayah, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply more
than 700
for whom he wants. So sometimes, even if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned 700 times, that means there is some levels. Like for example, if you do sadaqah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at least will write it 10 times. But if you hide it, and if you give the best money, like you do something extra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it 700 times, and maybe more. And there is another hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنِ آدَمَ لَهُ الْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا إِلَى 700 ضعف إِلَى أَضْعَافٍ كَثِيرًا إِلَى أَضْعَافٍ كَثِيرًا إلا إيش؟ إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that all the deeds of the son of Adam, it's for him. 10 times to 700 times to whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Except soul, it's for me and I shall reward for it. So subhanAllah. And there is another ayah. مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. So it's very clear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the most generous one, and He multiply without counting. He can multiply more than 700. And what about the bad deeds?
One thought.
Or
he removes.
Or forget. So subhanAllah, see the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You become Muslim, you will keep all your good deeds, all bad deeds will be removed. And then the qasas will start. Now the charge will start. How the charge start? How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would charge you? One hasana to 10 times, or 700 times to whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. One sayyah, that's it. It will remain a one sayyah, or maybe Allah will forgive. So subhanAllah, look to the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how He deal with us according to His mercy, not according to our a'mal, to our deeds. And He gives those people their ajr twice. We don't get this reward. You know why? Why you don't have this opportunity as a born Muslim person. Because for you, Islam comes as something
automatic.
You just find your parents Muslims, and for the other people, they get their ajr twice because it's very difficult for them to leave whatever they practiced before, and they realize the truth, and then follow the truth. It's not something easy. It's very difficult to do it. And before this, this is similar to the hadith that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-mahir bil Quran," the one who like do recite the Quran perfectly, he is with the noble angels. And the one who find the Quran very difficult, and he try and do his best more and more and more, he said he gets his ajr
double,
twice, two times. Now, what's your question?
I mean, when God speaks about fasting, I mean, he speaks about Ramadan?
Any fasting.
Okay,
any fasting. We know that if you fast, if you offer an extra fast, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will distance your face from the hellfire 70 years. Yes. And we're talking about distance. Do you realize he said 70 years? Okay, so years is time or distance?
Both.
Yeah.
It's time. Right? So he said he will make you far from the hellfire 70 years.
Yes.
Now we said, you know, As-sana al-dawiyya, which is the light, the light here, is distance or time?
Both.
It's distance, but it's taken from the time. That means how the light would like how long the light would
travel.
Go or travel during a 1 year. So same here. You don't know, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you that far from the hellfire. So at that time, maybe they didn't realize like why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will distance your face 70 years. And years is time. Right? So it's a trouble of 70 times. Of 70 years. SubhanAllah.
And what is this speed, the trouble?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows better.
And some of the hadith, when Prophet mentioned sometimes the distance, he would say men with horse would travel, which means
yes.
Time is described as distance.
Yes.
That's an indication.
We didn't realize that until then later. Yes, yeah. What's your question? Okay. This is before and this is after. Do you know how? This guy, he's not Muslim.
Can you repeat the question in English?
Okay. So the brother asked, like, how can we put the two things that I mentioned, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would give them their rewards twice, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply the ajr to the al-'aaf kathira, to many times, more than 700. So when he become Muslim, that is possible. All his bad deeds will be removed, and all his good deeds will be considered as a good deeds, even though he didn't do it for the sake of Allah. And this is the condition of getting the a'mal accepted. If you don't do the a'mal for the sake of Allah, will not get accepted. But Allah, with His mercy, will make this good deeds countable for you, and maybe He would change your bad deeds to good deeds. So this is one ajr. And the next ajr is when you do good deeds after you become Muslim. So you have the ajr after the Islam with the right conditions, with when you apply all the conditions. And you even, you don't qualify to the ajr before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you as extra ajr. And For the multiply, it's after. After you become Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write at least, each hasanah 10 times. 700 times, to whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Clear? Jazakallah khair. Any other question? So this is the hadith that reported by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, radiyallahu ta'ala an. Jazakumullah khair, wa barakallahu fikum.